The pandemic has been so hard on the Michigan economy and so many small businesses.
Now we're seeing several long-standing family-owned companies disappear. Local 4 business editor Rod Maloney gives us the story behind the last days of the Michigan Ladder Company.
The Michigan Ladder Company opened on the banks of the Huron River here in Ypsilanti back in 1901. And over that time, it has expanded the factory a couple of dozen times, and it became the oldest and then only wooden ladder manufacturer in the entire country. But as you can see behind me here, there are trucks with trailers. They're hauling everything away after an auction because the company's closed, and its owner Tom Harrison is beyond sad.
This is the kind of thing, Rod, that will, as I've said to others, will haunt me for the rest of my life. I mean, what is it that I could have done differently?
The historic black and whites give you the impression Michigan Ladder would continue selling millions of wooden and later fiberglass ladders globally. After all, it survived the 2009 downturn and chugged profitably into 2019.
In the fourth quarter of 2019, China began shutting down. And we didn't understand, of course, at that time that we had a pandemic on our hands.
Just as ladder parts started showing up again, the governor shut Michigan down. And no one could tell Tom if his 25-employee company qualified as an essential business. And by the time he started back up, competitors in states not closed took over.
So you're talking 2 to 3 months of essentially being out of business. And in this day and age, and I understand this, customers don't want to wait. If they can get product from another source, they'll do that. I understand that.
Then last year, the global economy ground to a halt.
Could we have survived any one or two of those? I think we could have. All three of them together just became too much for us.
The former Ford and Carhartt executive knew the company he bought in 2004 had to close. Sadly, he told employees in January, but closed for good today.
I'm disappointed. Everybody here is disappointed.
Tom Harrison tells me that most of his employees did find other work. For him, he's not sure what is next. But he says this is one tough lesson to show exactly how quickly a business can go south. And he says Michigan has lost one small manufacturer, but a large bit of its history. In Ypsilanti, Rod Maloney, Local 4.